رأيت جسمك الساعات نحتا وتدعوك المنون دعاء صدق ألا يا صاح أنت أريد أنت أراك تحب عرسا ذات خدر أبت طلاقها الأكياس بتا تنام الدهر ويحك في غطيط بها حتى إذا مت انتبهتا فكم ذا أنت مخدوع وحتى متى لا ترعوي عنها وحتى أبا بكر دعوتك لو أجبتا إلى ما فيه حظك لو عقلتا إلى علم تكون به إماما مطاعا إن نهيت وإن أمرتا ويجلو ما بعينك من غشاها ويهديك السبيل إذا ضللتا وتحمل منه في ناديك تاجا ويكسوك الجمال إذا عريتا ينالك نفعه ما دمت حيا ويبقى ذكره لك إن ذهبتا هو العضب المهند ليس ينبو تصيب به مقاتل من أردتا وكنز لا تخاف عليه لصا خفيف الحمل يوجد حيث
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه أمهات المؤمنين وعلى من اتبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, I'm your host Kareem Abu Zaid. And this is the night of the Seerah, the night of the Seerah. Seerah in contemporary context, that's the name I chose. So this is the today is Tuesday. We do the Seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And brothers and sisters in Islam, we have been doing that for the last 13 lectures. We're simply trying to read the Seerah, the biography of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in light of our lives today. Focusing mainly on events in the life of our messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companions, and these events somehow address today's life, contemporary. And I'm telling you, this is how the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, brothers and sisters in Islam, should be read and it should be addressed. The seerah is not a fairy tale where you tell stories and entertain yourselves. Yes, it's nice. It's actually a good iman boost too. But the seerah is there for us to learn lessons from, inshallah. Some of you may be new to the class. But inshallah, brothers and sisters in Islam, I will try to update you. So this is Seerah in contemporary context. That's the name of the book which I'm authoring now. I'm done with volume one, alhamdulillah, which is the pre-prophethood. And this is lecture number 14. We've done 13 lectures already. And if you're interested in listening to some of these lectures, they are available on YouTube. Inshallah, maybe later on we'll make these links available for you, inshallah. But this is what we have, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, brothers and sisters in Islam. So Seerah in contemporary context. This is Islamic Online University to the right and Darul Tawheed. This is we're working together, inshallah, myself and Dr. Bilal Phillips. May Allah bless him, ya Rabbil Alameen. So inshallah, brothers and sisters in Islam, hopefully you will benefit. So we're addressing the third stage, which is the youth of the Prophet, which is the stage of revelation. The stage of revelation. For you to understand what I'm talking about, okay, this is all reviewing, we're reviewing today. We divided the biography of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam into 63 years. We have a 63 years total number. This is how long the Prophet lived. 40 before, 23 after. 40 before, 23 after. The first volume is dealing with the 40 before, which is the one that we're still studying now. The one that you're studying now with me now. We're actually hitting the end of it. So the 40. As for the 23, we divided it into two parts. Into two parts. Pre-prophethood, but first the pre-prophethood. We talked about his birth and his childhood. Then we talked about his youth. We finished that already. In the last 10 lectures, we done 10 lectures there, or maybe 11 lectures. And the stage of revelation, which is the stage we're talking about right now, this is lecture number 3. This is lecture number 3, talking about the initial revelation the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam received, brothers and sisters in Islam. طيب, regarding the 23 years, we divided it based on Mecca and Madani. 13 years in Mecca, 10 years in Medina, inshallah. We're going to study this in volume 2 and volume 3. The Meccan period, we also divided it into 3. You don't have to worry about this now. We're going to do this later, inshallah. But we're still dealing with volume 1, which is what? We're talking about the 40 years before the prophethood, before the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was appointed to be a messenger, brothers and sisters in Islam. 40 years. طيب, the pre-prophethood, we talked about his childhood. We already done that. The first 13 lectures deal with that. We talked about his youth. We done that too. It's over. Now we're dealing with the third stage, which is the revelation, the time when the Prophet went to the cave and all of that. And this is lecture number 3. So now we should know where we are now. Where we are now. Now, once it comes to lecture to the third stage, chapter one right here, we talked about should we associate or isolate, basically, what should we do, right? And then we talked about contemplation or tafakkur. And this is the subject which we have today, inshallah, brothers and sisters in Islam. Now I'm going to jump into the area where I want to address today. Okay, so at least you know what we're dealing with now. For you to grasp the subject of today, which is amazing, the subject of yoga. Yoga. But amazing. This subject is originated, or we got it from the Seerah. How? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he could not handle or change his community, who were totally indulged into polytheism, into shirk, into corruption, into all type of wickedness, lewdness, evil. Subhanallah, brothers and sisters in Islam, when you reach that stage, you have to separate yourself. And that applies to us too. You see, if you cannot change with your tongue or with your hand, then the last place you have to resort to is your heart. But here is something that a lot of Muslims don't pay attention to. When you resort to the heart, you have to build the wall between you and the people. You cannot talk to, or you cannot force the change on them. Seclusion, isolation. Because if you stay around them, they will corrupt your heart. They will get to you, brothers and sisters in Islam. So this is what the Prophet did. Towards the end of those 40 years, he started loving being alone out there on the top of one of the highest mountains in Mecca called Jabal al-Nur, in a small tiny cave. Imagine, the small tiny cave for him was more expansive than the whole of Mecca. Why, brothers and sisters in Islam? Because someone with firm beliefs, when he sees something wrong and he cannot do something about it, he feels frustrated. He feels bad. And the only way, if I cannot do anything about it, I have to go somewhere else. So The people said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when he went to the cave, he did something called Taffakur, contemplation, Taffakur, yoga. That's where the yoga comes handy. You're getting that. So you're getting now the relevance between yoga and this. So they say the Prophet was out there in order to do tafakkur, in order to do. Now we spoke about tafakkur in the previous lecture before we took that long break for Hajj and Ashura and Hijra and Ashura. We mentioned that we have two extremes once it comes to the subject of reflection, reflecting. One extreme that says that what? Reflecting is better than worshipping Allah for 1,000 years. And they say the Prophet said that. Meaning that you can give up the mandatory acts of worship and sit and just reflect, do like this. Do like this. Nobody said that. That's bogus. And we have another extreme, which is what? They say, no, don't even do that stuff. This stuff has, no. Reflecting and pondering, brothers and sisters in Islam, is an act of worship, which is neglected, which actually can boost your faith, affirm you. But here are the areas where you should reflect upon. Number one, the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إن في خلق السماوات والأرض واختلاف الليل والنهار لآيات لأولي الألباب. The moon, the sun. Who created this? That should lead you to what? Especially the system. Especially if you go into studying the system of the planets around us, the planet Earth, or even the human. The human, so that should always lead you to say Subhanallah, Subhanallah. And remember when we spoke about Tawheed, this is actually the entry to Tawheed, the intellectual. Who created this? First of all, he must be a creator. Two, this creator must be much better than what he created. So this is the first type. The second type is reflecting upon al-ayat al-Qur'aniyya, al-wahy, which is called tadabbur. That you read the Qur'an with tadabbur. You reflect upon the Qur'an. أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنِ. How come they don't reflect upon the Qur'an? They have to reflect upon the Qur'an. So when you read the Qur'an, you reflect upon it. So this is the second type. The third type, shaitan comes to us sometimes and he tries to get us to reflect and think about the nature and the reality of the essence of Allah, his attributes. Shaitan plays this game a lot on us. He tries to get us to visualize Allah in a certain way. Don't do this. And the hadith, hadith Abdullah ibn Umar, the Prophet says what? تدبروا في آلاء الله ولا تدبروا في الله. Reflect upon the things which Allah created, but do not run your intellect regarding Allah and His divine essence. Reflect upon the throne, and all of that, but do not reflect upon what? Upon the essence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is number three. Number four is to reflect upon your own self and your own life, which we call calling yourself to account. What did you do with your life so far? If you are to die today, are you ready to go? Did you send something for tomorrow, brothers and sisters in Islam? Did you send something for tomorrow? Are you ready to go? You see, that is the second type of tadabbur, brother, the fourth type of tadabbur. Hasibu, Umar ibn al-Khattab said, call yourselves to account before you're called to account. Hasibu anfusakum qabla an tuhasabu. وزنوا أعمالكم قبل أن توزن عليكم. The final type of the of tadabbur, brothers and sisters in Islam, is you reflect upon the fate and what happened to the previous nations who lived before us, who rejected Islam, who rejected the teachings of the messengers and the prophets, and they end up destroyed. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the LGBT, whatever they are dominating the system now. Some of you may have watched that video of Brother Eddie, how they are penetrating the education system in America and trying to get our children confused about their gender just to prepare them to go to their way. There was a nation before us, brothers and sisters in Islam, who were destroyed. They were destroyed. So we need to reflect upon that. Reflect upon that. Reflect upon the people who rejected the message and the messengers and rejected Islam, and what were the consequences of doing this. Now I want to ask you a question. Have you ever heard me saying yoga? Do yoga? Amazing. Amazing, brothers and sisters in Islam. I want to discuss the subject of yoga with you today, inshallah, in that little time I have, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. Brothers and sisters in Islam, I know that some of you are trying to call, but please, if you can hold, at the end, inshallah, we're going to take some phone calls, inshallah, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. So, the definition of yoga, and this is, by the way, coming from people who studied the subject, from cultural and from religious aspects. Yoga is both spiritual and physical exercise which aims at connecting with God. Actually, there is a typo here, right here. It's God, not good, with God. I'm sorry, there is a typo here in the second line. Please forgive me. There is a typo here. I did this. So, with God, like the concept of the unity of the being, wahdatul wujud, the mystic Muslims, the extreme Sufis believe in. You see, the extreme Sufis believe that a created can become one with the creator. And that's what yoga is all about. That you reflect and you do certain polytheistic rituals, like calling upon the sun, looking at the sun, bowing down to the sun, bowing down to the moon, or doing these certain rituals, in order to what? To attain that unity with the spirit, with the universal spirit, which is God. They mean God. Right there from the get-go? No. Here is the scholar who defined this. He said, yoga in the sacred Indian language means union and contact with God. The union between the body, the mind, and the God helps man attain knowledge and wisdom, and develops his thoughts by developing his knowledge of life. That's how it is. That's how it is, brothers and sisters in Islam. Another definition which we have here, Jamil Sulaiba, that's his name, also defined yoga, and he said, it refers to a kind of a spiritual exercise that is practiced by the wise men of India for union with the universal spirit. Clearly, brothers and sisters in Islam, from the above definitions, we can conclude the higher purpose of this yoga business, the higher purpose of the yoga is what? Is to connect with God. Now, someone who studied Know Your Lord, Volume 1, from the Right Belief series, some of you may be new to my classes here, but someone who studied that, will he buy that? Will he buy that? Will he buy that? No. Please, I want to see some no. I want to see some typing. No, 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 no. Absolutely not. Absolutely not. All right? طيب. That's what I said. The means to obtain this unity are regular activities and polytheistic rituals the founders of the practice introduced them, such as prostrating to the sun, there should be no doubt the whole concept of yoga is an idol worshipping concept, or originates from an idol worship. Muslims who hold the correct belief system, like you, inshallah, like me, inshallah, by the will of Allah, according to the first three braised generations, in no way can accept the objective of the act of yoga, as well as the means, the polytheistic rituals, to attain this goal, because of the following reasons. There are some reasons which I mentioned, brothers and sisters in Islam. Let's go over them. If you have a question, just type it and I will go back and answer it, inshallah. I'll answer you, Sharjil, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. If you have a question about something that I explained, please just post your question and I will try to answer it, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. Tayyib. Next. The reasons why we cannot accept yoga. Number one. The belief in the divine essence of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. We affirm the attribute of the divine essence for Allah without negation. Remember that. Without resembling. Without interpretation. And without dictating the nature and the reality, which we call the how. We don't do that. So now, yoga is about turning God into a spirit, which is all over the place, where you can unite with that spirit. You're getting that? Oh. So you, that's right away. It's contradictory to Tawheed. So that's the first reason. The second reason, brothers and sisters in Islam, where is Allah? Where is Allah? What do we believe? Where is Allah? Huh? Where is Allah? Allah is above the throne, subhana. Allah is above the throne, subhana, in a way that suits His Majesty. Don't employ your intellect to figure out how. In a way that suits His Majesty and greatness. That's it, and leave it at that. Okay? Now you want to tell me that God can come down to unite with you when you sit and do like this? And bow down to the sun and the moon and invoke and do these exercises? God is going to come and unite with your spirit? No. There is no such a thing in Islam. Okay? So that's reason number two. Tab, reason number three. The means to get there are polytheistic. Because if you look into the exercises of yogas, they normally have to do with bowing down and prostrating to the sun. Sometimes invoking elements of the universe. They cannot tolerate such practices. They are all polytheistic. They are according to the practitioners. These practices include, and not limited to, prostrations and bowing down to the universal elements such as the sun, the moon, and imploring them. That's all shirk. Another reason, brothers and sisters in Islam, you are encouraging the devious sect of the mystic Sufis. Because that's what they believe in, mystic Sufis, which is the religion actually the West wants. You know, like Paul changed Christianity, for them, Sufism is the way to modify and reform Islam. And one of the pillars, main principles of Sufi, of mystic, is God is not an essence. God is a spirit. And you can unite with God, which we call wahdatul wujud, the unity of the being. You can be God if you do certain rituals, certain, if you dance for a while. Some sects, actually, if you smoke some hash for a while, you know, you can actually become like that. Doing this, in a way, you are promoting, advancing the agenda of the extreme Sufis. I think the last reason here is we're imitating non-Muslims. We are imitating non-Muslims or imitating people who practice innovation. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said fi hadith ibn Umar fi sunan Abi Dawud, whoever imitates others, he is like them. So this is also another reason, brothers and sisters in Islam. Also another very interesting thing which I came across, look at this. Path to salvation is Islam. We believe that the only way for you to go to Jannah is La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Now guess what? We cannot accept the practice of yoga because based on the definition of the concept of unity of man with the being, which is God, yoga aims at creating and developing the ideology of the truth is not in one single religion. Indeed, it is in all the religions and the philosophies combined. Such beliefs will not be condoned by Islam at all, brothers and sisters in Islam. So hopefully now I want to say no to yoga. I want to write down, say no to yoga, say no to that. Say no to that, brothers and sisters in Islam. Remember that you can reflect. You can reflect upon the universe. You can reflect upon the Quran. You can reflect upon the Sunnah. You can reflect upon your own self, what you have done. You can reflect upon the great things which Allah created, the throne, the footstool, the angels. You can reflect upon this, but not about Allah. You can reflect upon what happened to the disobedient nations before you. You can reflect upon all of that. You can listen, I'm not canceling this out, but not with yoga. Not with yoga. Don't tell me I'm going to sit down, I'm going to do these five things while I'm doing yoga. No, you're not supposed to do that, brothers and sisters in Islam. One last point here. Despite all the above reasons, some jurists, despite confessing to the apparent link between the spiritual and the physical of the yoga practice, yet they say what? Look at this now. That's where, you know, brothers and sisters, wallahi, you get tired from these people. Ya akhi, tell me it's halal or haram, so I move on. I said, okay, you can do yoga, provided that you do not associate it with the polytheistic practices and you don't believe in that unity of the being. Why? Do you need yoga to do this? Do you need yoga to do this? Can't you just come up with some practices? The answer is no. You will find these guys, you know, telling people, yeah, yoga is fine, provided that you do not you separate the physical exercise from the belief attached to them. You don't do that. But this opinion, brothers and sisters in Islam, is invalid because of its religious origins and the resemblance to those idol worshippers and our ability to produce our own physical practices, Muslim practices. علموا أولادكم السباحة والرماية وركوب الخيل. Umar said that in some narration. Teach your children how to swim. Teach your children how to... You do not need these practices. You see, the intellectual side, we set the five areas. You could do this while you're sitting down and so forth, brothers and sisters in Islam. With this, inshallah, hence, yoga is forbidden altogether. And don't look at these halfway solutions, because these are not good for you, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. Brothers and sisters in Islam, with this, inshallah, I am done with the class today. Inshallah, we're going to move to chapter 2 from the stage of revelation. And you're going to enjoy this chapter, because the first encounter, the Prophet has been waiting for months, has been spending time for months, for nights and days. And now he's inside the cave. By all the sudden, he's going to have a visitor, unexpected, by all the sudden. The first contact between Jibreel alayhi salam and the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And this is chapter 2, next Tuesday, inshallah, the same time, brothers and sisters in Islam. Now, you can go ahead and call the number 303-500-5101. Go ahead and call, inshallah, if you wish to give us a call. But meanwhile, let me see if I have any questions here. May Allah reward you, Sister Naima, for your dua. Barakallah fiki. Maryam, so let me, Shiraf from Sri Lanka, assalamu alaikum, Sister Muhammad. I'm glad you were able to make it, Sister Muhammad, in spite of the time difference. Lawani Ismail, wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Our dear Abu Bakr Muhammad, all the way from Houston, Dallas, wa alaikum assalam. Nigar Burhan, wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Naima, wa alaikum assalam, Sister Naima. Maryam, wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We have, okay, let me see if I can pick this up. I did the setup, hopefully it will work. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Assalamu alaikum, this is Muhammad.
Yes,
I'm calling you from Georgia.
Okay, brother Muhammad.
Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Yeah. I have a question. In our masjid, we pray Jamaat like three times. Fajr in Isha and Maghrib, but other time that is closed. So can we do Jamaat with my wife at home, like,
yeah, absolutely,
two people?
You're encouraged, yeah, 100% Muhammad, yeah. I mean,
in another thing, like, if the inside of masjid
I'm not
is closed,
sure. Can you hold on 1 second, Muhammad?
Inside of masjid is closed.
Okay, brother Muhammad, can you hold on, please? Can you hold on? Brothers, can you let me know if you can hear Muhammad or not on the broadcast? You see, I worked on this and I'm hoping. I have a caller. I'm talking to somebody actually on the other line. Can you guys hear him?
Okay.
Can you hear him? Can you hear him? Can you just guys tell me yes or no, please? If you can hear brother Muhammad, if you can hear him, that means I'm successful in the setup today. If not, then I'm going to have to do something else. But brother Muhammad, yes, we can. MashaAllah. So you can hear him. Beautiful. We can hear him. Okay, great. Allahu Akbar. Takbir. I did it. You know, I had to do all of this setup, a new studio down in my office here in the masjid. MashaAllah, that's great. So, Brother Muhammad, the answer to the first question, yes, you can do that. What is the other question?
You know, the question is like, like two times, like the masjid inside is closed, so I can pray outside, but it is hot. So, what do you prefer, to go there, pray alone, or pray at home with my family?
If you can make arrangements with some other brothers that you can pray outside the masjid, and try to bring a little tent, you know, a little bit tent or somewhere, or find a tree. Prepare some place in the outside. Mm-hmm. This is a lot better. But if you cannot, then I encourage you to pray with your family.
No, but I can outside, but I will pray like alone with nobody. But at home, I can
then,
pray at least with
then
my wife.
Then pray with your family at home, Muhammad, okay?
Okay, really appreciate it. Thank you so much.
Jazakallah khair.
Barakallah. I really benefit that.
Make dua, inshallah.
Thank you so much.
Okay, brothers, give us a call, inshallah. Mashallah, the setup is working. I was so much afraid that it's not working. We have another 20 minutes. Please give us a call, inshallah. Please give us a call, inshallah. 303-500-5101. The number shown on the screen right here. Let me pick up some more questions from the broadcast here. We don't want to neglect our brothers. Tears of snow and silent dua from your sister from the Netherlands. How are you, sister from the Netherlands? May Allah bless you. May Allah bless you, sister. You as well, inshallah. May Allah reward you for your dua. Wallah, I need your dua. Please keep making dua for me and my family. Alva Zakaria. Wa alaykum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alva Zahra. I'm sorry, Zahra, not Zakaria. Alva Zahra. Okay, here you go. We have Sharjil. Okay, let me see. Okay, we have brother Sharjil. Wa alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Okay, let me back up this one. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Shalom.
Wa alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
My name is Abdullah and calling from BI. Sheikh, what is the ruling on Sheikh, what is the ruling on reciting conjoined dhikr after Salah, like Ayatul Kursi and Qul Allahu Ahad?
The ruling on doing it in a congregation, you mean? Like together with the
like
other people?
Reading it with your family.
Yeah, like in a congregation manner, together.
Yes.
That should not be done. Only one case that you're trying to teach your family and help them memorize the adhkar, then you may do that.
Yes.
And you have to alert them first that these adhkar should be done individually, silently. But we're doing this for the sake of educating you and teaching you how it is done. And maybe if we repeat it a couple of times together, it will be easy for you to grab the order and maybe memorize some of it. You got that?
Yeah.
Jazakallahu khaira. Barakallahu feek. We have brother Robin. Robin, give us a call, brothers. The lines are open. Flags of Sami Yusuf, I don't know what that means. Salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Anas Nur, wa alaykum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Nigar Burhan, wa alaykum salam. In the start of the month of Muharram, I ask you about, can we make intention for our missed fast in Ramadan? You said you cannot. Sheikh Asim said we can I got confused. We don't have to agree, me and Sheikh Asim, on everything. As long as brothers and sisters in Islam, we agree on the fundamentals of the religion. Let me just pick up this and I will come to you, Nigar, okay? Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Hello?
Assalamu alaikum. Assalamu alaikum. Hello, your life, please.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Can you please?
Shaker, how are you?
Alhamdulillah. Can you turn down the.
Alaikum assalam wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh.
Can you turn down whatever you're watching, because we can't hear you? It's very noisy. Okay, sister, you have to talk to me over the phone because there are...
Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum assalam. Please talk to me from the phone because there is a split of 15 seconds between the broadcast and our phone call.
Okay. This on the phone, Imam Karim. How are you?
Alhamdulillah. How are you, sister?
Alhamdulillah. This is Sister
Aisha
from Maryland.
Yes, Sister Aisha. How are you doing? What is your question? PGMA.
The question,
College
yes,
Park.
I can hear you. The question I have is pertaining to the class I just finished. Regarding what should be the response be to those brothers and sisters who give excuses like that says, oh, it's permissible to do yoga because it has nothing to do with the deen.
Stay away from them. If you cannot, remember what I said at the very beginning, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam could not change his condition. He could not tell them this is wrong. They are not listening to him. He decided to go to the cave. Okay? Anybody who violates Islam, be nice to them, be kind to them, give them da'wah in the kindest, nicest, lenient way possible. As long as they allow you. The moment that they disallow you, the moment that they are not responding to you, then build that wall between you and them. Jazakallah khairan, Sister Asiatu. Assalamu alaikum. So I go back to Nigar. It's up to you. You know, at the end of the day, your intention is making up the day. If you get the reward for Ashura, alhamdulillah. But my opinion is no combination of voluntary and mandatory, two voluntaries. That's my opinion. That's the area where Islam is so beautiful that you could differ. You could differ on something. That's okay, inshallah. Now it's up to you. There is a line out there which says what? Al-muqallidu mujtahidun. مجتهد في اختيار من يقلد. The blind follower, which is supposedly you now, you're trying to follow me or Sheikh Asim, you must do ijtihad in choosing between me and Sheikh Asim. And by the way, there is nothing wrong with Sheikh Asim's opinion, and now there is nothing wrong with my opinion. Okay? So it doesn't matter, because we're not talking about something that we have evidence. It's something which out there open. Evenless. All right. مالك، السلام عليكم مالك. نعيمة، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. مالي هالي، وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. أوكي، فاروق جاجي، وعليكم السلام سيستر رحيمة، ويلكم باك ما شاء الله. أوكي، وي هاف نعيمة أحمد، وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. سالي موسى، مي الله ريورد يو أز ويل. حسين ديدي، وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. مي الله ريورد يو. ويت تومورو، وي هاف سورة المؤمنون إن شاء الله. 3 دايز، ماندي تيوزداي وينزداي، وي هاف 3 لايف كلاسز إن شاء الله. أوكي، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. السلام عليكم.
Walaikum salam, Sheikh. This is Amalia from Minnesota.
Yes, Sister Amalia. How are you doing? Minnesota.
Alhamdulillah, Sheikh.
How are the
I
kids?
I have a question.
How are the kids?
Yes. Alhamdulillah. So, I am from Indonesia, and I didn't know until lately I find out that what I recite on my salah, it wasn't according to sunnah. So, can I stop reciting them, just like, you know, just like before saying Al-Fatiha, I say Allahu Akbar Kabiro Walhamdulillahi Kathiro and blah blah blah. That's what I learned from Indonesia.
Alhamdulillah, now you can fix it.
Yes, so, huh?
Now you can fix it.
Yes, yes.
Alhamdulillah.
So I just quit doing that and just learn what I have to do, right, Sheikh?
Yeah. Are you worried about your salah in the past?
About the past? They already passed, right? It's okay.
Yeah, but are you worried about it?
Huh?
Are you worried that they are not valid now anymore?
Yeah, I was before, but I kind of...
Alhamdulillah.
Well, it's okay.
You see, as long as you did not know, you're in good hands. Allah is so merciful. وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيُضِيعَ إِيمَانَكُمْ أي صَلَاتَكُمْ. Because, subhanAllah, when the Muslims, sister Emilia, migrated from Mecca to Medina, they prayed toward Jerusalem for 17 months. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directed them to pray back to Mecca. So they said, what about the salah that we prayed toward Jerusalem? You know, as long as it's a command, in your case, as long as you did not know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so merciful. Jazakallah khair. May Allah reward you. Barakallah feek, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum.
Jazakallah khair.
Okay, give us a call. We still have another 10 minutes, guys. Inshallah, give us a call. Wa kabir wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Okay, let me see here. Sharjil. Okay, we have Sharjil question here. Should the tadabbur be in the order which you stated? Not necessarily, Sharjil. The mom should call it. When you're reading the Quran, then you should do that Quran. When, you know, the time is right, reflect upon the creation. When you're driving on the highway and you see these mountains, you see the green, Allah gives you that beautiful sunset or sunrise. So let the moment call you to do this. Obviously, calling yourself to account, you know, at the end of the year, at the beginning of the year, at the end of the day, when you wake up for Fajr, and so forth, inshallah. Barakallah feek. Okay, we have Danladi. Wa alaykum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Okay, can we do yoga without spiritual thing? Okay, I think we answered that. Flags of Sami Yusuf, we answered that. No. No. Okay. Wa kabir, how do we see, imagine Allah when we pray with ihsan, as if we can see Him? Can I imagine a light advice? Don't do that, brother Wakabir. That's where shaitan gets us. You know, that's where shaitan gets to us. Don't do this. Just focus on the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and remember Allah is watching you. Sharjil, there are stretches that may doctor advise me to do. There is nothing wrong. Medical. I'm talking about the practices of yoga. The things that come in a book. What should you do, right or left? But a doctor tells you to do some physical work. There is nothing wrong with that. There is nothing wrong. They may look like it, but there is nothing wrong with that. Hopefully this is clear, Sharjil. We have Naima Ahmad, wa alaykum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We have Idris, wa alaykum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Jilal Banur, wa alaykum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Okay, there is, if you're going to too many places and the story is still the same, what you, okay, I don't know what are you going with that, dear brother? I don't know what are you going with that. Okay, Astaghfirullah, brother, why do you want to imagine the creator? Okay, I can answer them. Take it easy on him, okay? Take it easy on him. ABA, be easy on the guy. You know, he asked in a nice way, and let's educate one another, okay? Okay, the sister from Netherlands, I have a question about nature. Gem stones, they say some stone, like, for example, herbs, regulate certain health issues. Can we use it, wear it? What is the view of... I'm not sure if they tell you, I mean, wearing it and all that stuff, I don't know how. There is no medical way out of this, but I hope you don't believe that there is something holy about them. Alhamdulillah, everybody's saying no to yoga. Thank you, brother. Sister Noura Rashid, hopefully changing the time didn't harm you, Sister Noura. Not to yoga, alhamdulillah, all good. If somebody asked me a question, but I'm doing dhikr or reading the Quran, can I just ignore them or someone? I think you should answer them, inshallah. Be nice. It depends on the person. First of all, if they should be, if they see you engaged in the remembrance of Allah, then they should leave you alone. But, you know, if they don't, then try to be nice and answer them quickly and go back to your dhikr, inshallah. Maryam, what response should we give to the Muslims who see nothing wrong with yoga? Okay, I can answer that, Maryam. You called, I think. Yes, you can hear. Okay, we're good here, we're good here, we're good here, we're good here. Okay, Muhammad Amir Farooq, wa alaykum as-salam, Muhammad Amir. I am Muhammad Umar. MashaAllah, Muhammad. How are you, Muhammad? Good to have you. Okay, let me see here. Safiya Ali Ibrahim, wa alaykum salam Safiya, sister Safiya, how are you? Brother Dean, Abu Bakr Muhammad, mashallah. Okay, our thing is sujood, ruku' and dhikr, for indeed the heart finds, yeah, that's our yoga, ruku' sujood, dhikr. Muhsin Hijazi, Muhsin Shirazi, thank you, jazakallah khair. May Allah allow you to see him. Ameen, Ya Rabbil Alameen. On the day of judgment, Ya Rab, Ya Rab. May Allah, and you too, brothers. May Allah reward you. Allah, this is a beautiful dua for me. You are fine. Okay, good, good, good. Praying five salahs is the best exercise. I agree. I think there are different opinions making it up intention. Okay. Why did the scholars of hadith take from the people of Bid'ah, even though they are lied upon the messenger? You have to give me an example so I can respond. There must be a reason. Alva, okay, let me see. Okay, let me see here from Pakistan. Fatuma, alaykum salam, from Kosovo, mashallah, mashallah. Fatloum Zika, mashallah, mashallah, good to have you. This is going to be the new timing. Yes, Sister Muhammad. Unfortunately, you see, I'm a principal here now in school, and I go home just dead tired, and it's family time, and you know, 6 o'clock, I want to have energy for you guys. So I decided to do here, inshallah. What is the stronger? But when the winter time comes, we're going to go down to 11. Winter time, we're going to go down to 11, 1 hour less, inshallah. What is the stronger opinion regarding reciting Fatiha behind the Imam? I have a video, I hope somebody can post it for you, reciting Fatiha behind the Imam. I'm not sure if my admins are working today, but if somebody can post that video for the brother, that would be very helpful, inshallah. Iqra' Maryam, assalamu alaikum. Sheikh, is prayer valid without wearing socks covering feet? For sisters, the top, yes, you should. The salah is valid. The salah is valid, but you certainly lose some reward there, inshallah. We have Bashkim. Assalamu alaikum. I love you. For the Jazakallah khair. May Allah reward you. May Allah reward you. May Allah reward you. May Allah reward you. Nigar, Sheikh, please remember us in your dua. You remember me as well. Pilates may be the halal alternative for yoga. I don't know what that is. I don't know what it is. Okay, let me see here. Mali Hali, dear Sheikh, please explain briefly, la hawla wala quwwata, la hawla wala quwwata illa billah. If you really want to understand la hawla wala quwwata illa billah, you have to believe that Allah creates what we do. You see, Allah creates the speech which I do now. That my speech right now, Allah creates it. You understand? Now, all what you have to do is to show intention. That's all. And that's how it is important. That's why we say, I cannot do anything without the might and the power of Allah. And, you know, inshallah, maybe in another time I will try to do this, inshallah. I still have a couple of more minutes here, inshallah. So, Noura, what if we do not wear socks? Salah isn't valid. Salah is valid, sister, but you lose some reward. You should try to stretch your clothes to cover at least the back of your feet. Cover the back of your feet, please, inshallah. Are you in the USA? Yes, I am in the USA, so I will know if we are the same time. Yes, I'm Mountain Standard Time. I'm in Denver, Colorado. Denver, Colorado. Rocky Mountain area. Assalamu alaikum. We have Sheikh. It is compulsory to cover feet. I can answer that. You know, I can answer that. Yes, the bottom of the feet are not awra. The back are awra. So that's what you need to cover, inshallah. I am from Dubai. Jazakallahu khair. Jazakallahu khair. Salma from Germany. MashaAllah. May Allah bless you. Muhammad Yusuf. Is it okay to have intimacy with wife when she had a ghusl without intention? You should ask her to do ghusl first to be in the safe side, inshallah. Jazakallahu khaira, brothers and sisters in Islam. Tomorrow we have the higher aim of the Quran, the tafsir. And brothers and sisters in Islam, we have Surah Al-Mu'minun, inshallah. Till tomorrow, I leave you all of you, in the care of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of you. May Allah give you Jannah, Rabbil Alameen. May Allah reward you tremendously, brothers and sisters in Islam. And please remember me in your dua as well. Jazakumullahu khayra. Assalamu alaykum.
خط فؤادك الأيام فتى وتنحت جسمك الساعات نحتى وتدعوك المنون دعاء صدق ألا يا صاح أنت أريد أنت أراك تحب عرسا ذات خدر أبت طلاقها الأكياس بتى تنام الدهر ويحك في غطيط بها حتى إذا مت انتبهتا فكم ذا أنت مخدوع وحتى متى لا ترعوي عنها وحتى أبا بكر دعوتك لو أجبتا إلى ما فيه حظك لو عقلتا إلى علم تكون به إماما مطاعا إن نهيت وإن أمرتا ويجلو ما بعينك من غشاها ويهديك السبيل إذا ضللتا وتحمل منه في ناديك تاجا ويكسوك الجمال إذا عريتا ينالك نفعه ما دمت حيا ويبقى ذكره لك إن ذهبتا هو العضب المهند ليس ينبو تصيب